Hey, there we go. 4 minutes, 4 o'clock. Talk about not what. Here we go. 4 minutes, 4 o'clock, fourth business day of the week. Here we are. What a day it has been. So we're Thursday. We're sitting out there. Snow. You could probably see the snow outside. You can also see that I came nowhere near brushing my hair at all today. And that was, of course, we had to shovel some snow this morning. Actually shoveled quite a bit of snow. So what were we supposed to be doing today? Tons of different things going on with the Speakers Bureau, tons of different things. Actually, something going on with me too, but everything's getting rescheduled. So Maria Fry was doing a real estate expo, a symposium kind of thing. For those in the industry, thinking about working in the industry, I've got the sun in my eyes, trying to keep my eyes open. There we go. So that is being rescheduled. Ty Vicari actually is. She's going to be in the Bryant Library, and that is actually taking place tonight, so you definitely want to go there. Really cool kind of thing. Besides the Bryant Library, it's the Christopher Morley Knothole Association. So Christopher Morley died a number of years ago. Very involved, very curious guy. He had gotten involved in a whole number of different things. So for the bibliophile, I think Ty calls herself, really into the books. Really a perfect organization for her to be speaking at. And also really interesting for what they're doing. The gentleman who started up that organization again is really into the whole thing. He is retired, so now he's able to do this more full-time, you know, but I've put a lot more effort into it. So he's going to be cruising along with that, my side of things. I was supposed to give a there we go. We're back again. A little tough time at the internet. But supposed to give a presentation, not a presentation tonight, motivational speech, Toastmasters. So we have our contest. Was supposed to be tonight. That'll also be rescheduled. There's two contests. One is the International Speech Contest, which is a motivational speech, 5 to 7 minutes. That is what I will be competing in. One at the club level, next is area. Then we go to division and district. Hopefully that all works out. But I was looking to give a 5 to 7 minute speech on that one. And then also the evaluation contest. So on that, somebody will give a presentation, also 5 to 7 minutes, and then I'll have 2 minutes, so along with the other contestants, to evaluate that speech, to give helpful hints and different ideas as to how they can make that speech more effective, but do it in a manner that is very supportive too. So, for all you coaches out there that are thinking about why in the world would Toastmasters be good for me, evaluations. Big deal. So if somebody gives a speech, you're to evaluate that speaker. Inside of the speech contest, now my only consideration there is, am I providing value? Am I doing good for the speaker? Am I helping that speaker out? So that's one thing. But if you do it at the club level, it's different. Same thing, somebody will give a speech, you will then be asked to evaluate that speech. But not only are you looking to give ideas as to how that person can become a better speaker, you have to be very sensitive to a number of different things. One, the speaker, in this case with the contest, the target speaker, the person that's going up there, knows that they are going to be evaluated more definitively. Let's use that word, definitively, because it's a contest. But at the club level, you're giving an evaluation for that person, but you also need to take into consideration the other folks that are in that room. Meaning, if there's a new member in that room and you go up and you evaluate the speaker, let's assume I'm the speaker, you really go for the jugular, what I could be doing better in my speech, and you give real specific, you might be scaring the bejeebies, and I could use that word over the internet, bejeebies, out of one of those other newer speakers that are afraid to get up there, and then like, oh my gosh, and then this guy's going to really rip me apart in my speech. So you really got to take that into consideration. So as a coach, you know that. And you're meeting with a new client for the first time, or even just beginning that relationship, you can't go crazy on giving them feedback. You got to ease into the whole thing, build trust, etc. So this is an interesting way of doing that. And on the international speech side of things, for those that have visions of glory, of getting in front of those bigger and bigger audiences, this is an unbelievable way of doing it, because you want to become really effective in your speech, and you also have a limited amount of time. So professional speakers, you know this. If you are told that you are to give a 22 and a half minute speech, you cannot go 23 minutes. You go 23 minutes, boom, you're never invited back again. If you go a little bit shorter, it's fine. You go over, not too good. So, you know, you got a real time management thing that's going on there. And then also from the motivational speaker side of things, like we all want to make an impact in someone's life, and that is my game also when I do any of my presentations. So I know we're probably coming up on the 4 minutes over here. What do we got there? Nick, Terry, Todd, good to see you there too. And I really appreciate everybody listening in on this one. So where do we become more effective? And I got an opportunity with Lisa Strohs-Lauren, one of our newer members of the Long Island Speakers Bureau. So on March 28th, she is doing a Books to Bucks program. So it's a school program, a career day over at Shoreham Wading River. I think there's a few more open slots too for the businesses that might want to participate in it. But she's given me the honor with two other people. We get to address the school in its entirety. So it'll be like 900 students. How much time we're going to have? Don't know. But I know that we have to end at 8:17. Regardless. So we're going to get an opportunity there to motivate those students, to make them take a look. And my message to them is that they should really be focusing on what it is that they are really doing, what clubs they're involved with, what community involved with, that kind of thing. Who makes the decision as to what video game that they're going to be playing, or what movie, or where they're going to go? Because all of those things lead to what is a possible career, or where they're at with it. It shows leadership skills if you're doing that. It shows creativity if you're trying to get a group of 10 people to decide on one thing. Gosh, can you imagine that? Getting 10 people to decide on one thing? You get 3 people, you get 15 opinions. It's a beautiful thing. But anyway, all of those things are clear indicators of where we should be going forward. And I was a monkey going back to the Wizard of Oz. Who knew I'd like doing these crazy things, and especially with people walking past. Hey, listen, I'm sure I'm over 4 minutes. Have a wonderful day, wonderful week, wonderful weekend. Hopefully it doesn't snow again. We'll speak to everybody next Thursday, fourth business day of the week, 4 minutes at 4 o'clock. And if you want to do the Shoreham thing, let me know. Man, there's still spots available for that. And then when we reschedule the Toastmaster thing, love to have everybody come down. It will be at some point in time in the future. Hey, have a wonderful day. Shovel safely and drive even safer. The latter folks out there, have a great day.